Morning, my friend. Forgive me.
No worries. Take him.
All right.
God bless you and take care, Christian Prince.
Take care. Thank you. Bye bye. Hello?
Yes, sir.
Hello, my friend. Are you a Muslim?
Yes, sir.
So, what do you want to say to us, Mr. Muslim?
I don't know what you've been talking about.
I'm talking here. I have a hadith in front of me. As long you know, you just call. First, let me welcome you, my friend, and your life on air. People, they can hear you. I have a hadith here, which is sahih. It says, the verse of stoning and adult and the breastfeeding for an adult 10 times was revealed, and the paper was with me under my pillow. When the Messenger of Allah died, we were preoccupied with his death, and a time sheep came and ate it. This is Aisha, the wife of the Prophet, speaking about how the Quran is missing verses. What do you say?
First of all, my name is Sheikh. I live in the United States, and I'm from Africa.
Okay.
What I would like to say is, clarify something is, I do not believe in some hadiths. I do not believe in that hadith because it contradicts the Quran.
You believe in what?
Everything that contradicts the Quran.
Okay, how does hadith contradict the Quran?
Yeah.
How does hadith contradict the Quran, my friend?
Because Allah said in the Quran that can you let me talk? I'm talking. I've been hearing cutting off people. I start saying something, you start cutting me off. You ask me a question, I'm answering.
I'm not talking, Abdul.
Give respect.
I'm not talking, Abdul. I'm listening. What's wrong with you? And why are you screaming?
Can we do that?
I'm not your wife to scream at me. Don't do that. Hello, Abdul. Be respectful. Speak as a man, not a kid. Now go ahead. Where is the contradiction? Where is the contradiction with this hadith in the Quran? Show me. Don't go play games. Where is the contradiction?
Okay.
Go ahead. Where is the contradiction? Go ahead.
And let me talk. You ask me a question. Let me
talk.
Answer.
Who's holding you, Abdul? Stop.
Shut up.
Stop. Get lost. Don't call me again.
I'm just saying. You ask me a question.
Don't call me again unless you want to speak as a man. Get lost. Obviously, you are trying to escape. This is why you are screaming. I did not scream at you. I did not even disturb you. What a liar. I feel sorry for your wife. What do you do with your family inside the house? Do you beat them every day? Stupid idiot, we are talking. Where is the contradiction between this hadith and the Quran? If you have an answer, call me. Hello?
Yes, are you sure? Why are you cutting me off?
Answer. What is the contradiction between this hadith and the Quran? Go ahead.
Okay. The Quran said in the crystal clear in the Quran that Al-Zaniyat wa Zani, whoever fornicates a man or a woman, got 100 lashes.
Is that Arabic you are reading now?
So I'm just telling you a verse of the Quran.
Hey, my friend, but is that an Arabic? I heard you saying something. Is that Arabic?
That was Arabic. Azaniyatu wa zani.
Where we can find this? Where we can find this verse in the Quran?
Oh, I thought you said you know the Quran.
Sure, I know the Quran. This is chapter 24, verse number 2. I know the Quran more than you, but I'm saying to you, where we can find this verse in the Quran? Do you know?
Does it matter?
Well, how come I know? How come I know the number? You do not know the number. I told you the number already, but look, you are slow. Chapter 24, verse number 2. Now I'm asking you, where we can find this verse in the Quran? Where we can find this verse in the Quran?
Goodness, can you? Since you know the Quran, can you tell people that I'm lying? That this verse isn't in the Quran?
It is in the Quran. I'm asking you where it is in the Quran. I said it is in the Quran, but where it is in the Quran? You do not know. You do not know. You do not know, right? Okay, you do not know. Chapter 24, verse number 2. Okay, now, what does this have to do with this hadith? Azaniya wa zani, which you do not know how to read.
This hadith you said is talking about stoning, right? You said stoning somebody who fornicates, no?
Yes.
I said you cannot stone because Allah said we give him 100 lashes.
No, the verse you are quoting for me is about adultery for people who they are single, not married.
Oh my God, does it say single or married?
It doesn't say that, but, this, but okay, do you want to challenge me, Abdul? Do you want to make a challenge? A challenge in front of everybody. That this is what it's meant. Do you want to challenge? Say yes. Be a man.
I'm gonna challenge you and the Bible and on the Bible.
Don't change the topic, Abdul. Do you want to challenge me that this is what the verse mean? It's about single people, not married people. Yes or no?
He never said no single or thing. He said azani. It was zani.
Abdul, why? Okay, what, so how we will understand the verse meaning now? Shouldn't we go to the interpretation? Yes or no?
So if I say any man or any woman that went to school, now you say that somehow you're talking about a young man or married man.
Abdul, don't waste my time. I'm not the one who's saying that. This is you Muslims who say that. You are a liar. Do you want me to get you busted? Yes or no?
You can't get me busted. Allah said somebody al-asari got was saying who.
Abdul, don't try to speak Arabic. You do not know Arabic. Now I'm asking you. Which interpretation you like me to read for you?
I need no interpretation.
You don't even know how to read Arabic. Okay, how you can give interpretation for the verse if you do not know how to read Arabic? Read the verse for me. Read the verse for me. Read, guys.
Allah said in the Quran.
Shut up. Go. Send me your dad. I don't have time for kids. Guys, read with me. This is Tafsir Ibn Abbas, the cousin of Muhammad. The adulterer and the adulteress who are unmarried and have not been married before, scourge them. Do you see it? This is a verse about people who they are not unmarried. If you are a donkey, this is not my problem. Let us take another one, Abdul. Hello. Yes, my friend. Go ahead.
Can you hear me?
Yeah, did you hear what we just said?
Hello?
Yes, I hear you, my friend. Go ahead.
You hear me?
I do.
Yeah, because I'm watching your YouTube video, so I should turn off my YouTube.
Better, you know, just stay with us. So, Hassan, did you hear what this guy he said about chapter 24, verse number 2?
That's Surah Tawbah?
Chapter 24, An-Nur.
An-Nur, yeah. Talking about the
is that about married people or this is about single people? What do you think?
What's the ayah?
I just told you, chapter 24, verse number 2.
What's he saying?
Azaniya wa zani, fajdudu kulla wahidun minhuma ma'at jalda. Is that about people who they are married? Is that about married? Is that about married adulterers or about single people?
Unmarried, single.
Unmarried, see? So why that Abdul before you, he was saying this is not about married people, unmarried people. Why Muslims lie? What do you think? What the reason?
What's the full? Because it's saying it's not stating actually from the Arabic.
But at the end of the day, you Muslims, you believe that this is about single people, correct?
For the lesser punishment is the ones who are not married yet.
Yes, okay. So why this guy who called me a second ago, he was lying saying this is not about married people.
Maybe he doesn't understand the language.
No, he was claiming, screaming at me and saying this is not about, it doesn't say married. And he claimed that this is about married. I told him this is about single people. He said no. So he was lying. Now, let me ask you. Hassan, my friend. As long as you agree with me that this is about unmarried people, what is the punishment for adultery in the Quran for married people?
It's killing, I think.
Where? What verse?
I can't remember. It's in the same chapter, Surah Nur. There's no verse
in the Quran about married people for adultery. The verse about adultery in the Quran is gone. The goat ate it. The one is says stoning to death. Stoning to death is a punishment for those who are married. Do you agree? Correct?
Which one?
Stoning to death punishment is a punishment for married people. Do you agree?
Yes, it's okay. The married one.
Wonderful. So where we can find the stoning to death punishment in the Quran?
For unmarried or married one?
Sorry?
For which one? For the unmarried?
I'm saying, no, the unmarried is in front of us. This is unmarried, chapter 24, verse number 2. All right. So this is for the unmarried, and both of us, we agree. And this is Tafsir Ibn Abbas, the cousin of your prophet, in front of our eyes. And it says clearly, this is for unmarried people. Now, where is the punishment for stoning, which is stoning to death in the Quran for those who they are married? Because according to Islam, if you are a married person and you do adultery, fornication, you will be stoned to death. What is the punishment? Where we can find it?
I'm not sure. I have to do more research on that.
No, I am sure. Here we go. The hadith says where it's gone. The goat ate it, my friend.
What's your reference for that?
Okay, here we go. We go to the reference, my friend. No problem.
Give me the reference for that. You cannot make up things.
No, we cannot. Sure, no, cannot. You see, this is why I use my screen, and nobody can say I'm making things.
No, no,
up.
Just give me the reference, the one that said it.
You can click at the I don't know if you can see YouTube. You can see the.
I can see your YouTube. All right, yeah. Now you're in Sunnah.com.
This is Sunan Ibn Majah. All right, and this is the Hadith, and the Hadith is accurate, is authentic. Hadith number variant number 3, book number 9, Hadith number 1944. It says, the verse of stoning to death, stoning and breastfeeding of an adult 10 times was revealed. So those are verses revealed, but yet we cannot find them. And the paper was with me under my pillow. When the Messenger of Allah died, we were preoccupied with his death, and a tame sheep came and ate it. Do you see it?
Yeah, the paper was hit under my pillow, and then a tame sheep came and ate it. And then what's the conclusion for that hadith?
And then this addition to that, it says, these verses were abrogated in recitation, but not in ruling. How is going to be abrogated? Yes, they are talking about later that there is the ten. Okay, I'm down. Don't you see it, all of that?
I want the verification if it's Hassan.
Yeah.
Go down.
Yeah.
Go down.
Which means it's authentic.
No, no, go down. You didn't show me that one. Huh? What's the authentication of this hadith, man?
It says Hassan, don't you see? It says Hassan. Do you know what Hassan means?
Hassan,
it's a rank of authentic hadith.
It's authentic.
It's authentic. It's authentic. It's Hassan. Hassan mean what? Hassan mean in Arabic? Can you tell me?
Hassan means is authentic. You can say authentic if I'm not wrong.
It means fine. It's fine.
Fine, but it does not reach the ultimate authentication.
Well, you know, there's ranks. Even the da'if, by the way, it's fine.
You don't know science of hadith.
My friend, even the da'if, you can go right now and search in YouTube, search for Sheikh Hamza. He made a speech about da'if hadith. And I'm quoting him word by word. He said, there's an attack on da'if hadith. Da'if hadith is the same as you say, a paper got F. It did not funk. It did not funk. You can go watch him and you can see. So even the da'if is accepted. So what about the Hassan? So this is
according to you, my friend, and Sunan Ibn Majah, not according to me.
I just name for you your Sheikh who is saying that. I name for you the Sheikh. I can show it to you.
I don't trust you. I don't follow him. He's a liar.
Okay, he's a liar. Now let me ask
Hamza is a Sufi.
Let me ask you.
He's a liar.
Okay.
Don't lie, please.
My friend.
I know him, Hamza. Hamza Yusuf is the scholar in US, if I'm not wrong.
He's what?
He is the scholar in US, United States.
I don't know, where is he?
Hamza is a Sufi, man. He worships the graves.
It doesn't matter. All of you worship the grave too. Aren't you a Muslim Sunni? Aren't you a Muslim Sunni? Let me ask you.
I give you time to talk. Come on, Prince. Be fair. Let me get across. Hamza is a Sufi. He comes from another sect. He worships a grave. He prays to a grave. How can you trust a man who worships a dead person? Come on, man.
Are you saying to me you don't worship a dead person? You don't worship a dead person, you?
I don't worship a dead person.
Okay. Your prophet in the hadith says that Allah curses those who build synagogue or a house of a prayer over graves. Is that correct?
Yes.
Okay. So why the grave of your prophet became a mosque now? And you are a Sunni?
Oh, the grave, the mosque was there before.
No, it was a grave, my friend. No, it was a grave because this is the house of Aisha. Never was a mosque. It was a house of Aisha. Okay. Yeah. Okay. So this was the house of Aisha.
The ruling is different.
No, my friend. Your prophet, he cursed those who build a synagogue or build a house of worship over a grave. So you and you are saying to me, you are saying to me the same. You are saying to me, Sufi are bad and they are not Muslims because they do that. Well, thank you very much. But you Muslim Sunni, you Muslim Sunni, you are not Sufi. You are not Sufi.
And you build. I'm not Sufi. So why are you quoting scholars of?
Now let me ask you. Let me ask you. Why we don't? Why we don't?
Are you quoting this?
My friend. My friend. My friend. What about you? Show me that Hadith Hassan is not accepted.
Admit to your followers, you
my friend. First. My friend, can you show me that Hadith is Hassan is not accepted?
Which one?
You said this Hadith is Hassan is not good for you, right?
But what's the end of the Hadith saying the verse was abrogated? So what's your point?
They are talking about abrogation by five verse, five breastfeeding. But even that one we cannot find in the Quran. Can you find me the verse where it says that there is five breastfeeding? There's 10 breastfeeding for adult. Your prophet, he taught. Okay, let us go there. Let's see if this fabrication or not. Let us go.
You have the chain of narration.
My friend, hold on. Yeah, the chain of narration. It's in the front of you.
Brother, you're gonna struggle. You have never understood.
My friend, you are the one who is struggling. Let me show you. You are saying that this is a lie. Let us see if it's a lie. First of all, this is a book. First of all, this is a
get across my point.
This is your book. Hold on. Let us show you. Let us see if this is an accurate story or not. Is Rida'atul Kabir? Is Rida'atul Kabir adult for breastfeeding is authentic or it's false? I'm listening.
Okay, continue.
I'm asking. Is Rida'atul Kabir authentic or it's false?
It's the breastfeeding of who?
What?
Breastfeeding of who?
Adult. Is it authentic or it's
intimacy.
Is it
sexual intimacy? What do you do in your bed? It doesn't matter, man.
Okay, so you are saying
so you don't suck.
Okay.
No. You don't suck your wife's boobs. Come on, man. Please.
Okay, so you agree if an adult he suck a woman,
that's sexual intimacy.
Thank
man.
You very much. I like that. I like that. So read with me this hadith. Read with me this hadith, which is sahih. Thank you, my friend. I appreciate it. I heard it. It's a sexual intimacy, but you're a prophet. He ordered a woman to give her boobs to a strange man. He is not her son. Read with me.
Come on, man.
And this is sahih Muslim. This is sahih Muslim. You cannot tell me now this hadith is not accurate. You can't play this game. Read with me. The woman, she said to him, how I'm going to do breastfeeding for him and he is a grown man.
Was the, is it authentic, this hadith?
Yes, this is sahih Muslim.
Go down, show me the word who quoted this hadith and verified it.
It's in the front of you.
You know sahih Muslim doesn't contain all the hadith are not authentic.
Ah,
you know
again, it's not sahih. You see, whatever we show them, it's not sahih. My friend, what the word sahih Muslim mean? What the word sahih Muslim mean? Then translate for me. What sahih mean?
Sahih Muslim authentic, yeah?
Okay, so the name of the book, you call the name of the book authentic Muslim, but it's not authentic, right?
Sahih Muslim is most authentic, if I'm not
okay.
Wrong.
So after, how you know now this one is not authentic, specifically this one? Do you sniff like a German shepherd? How you know how you were able to find out that this hadith is not authentic?
Sorry, I don't understand the hadith.
What do you mean understand? How you came to the conclusion that this hadith is not authentic? Did you sniff?
Sometimes you know all the hadith some are recorded.
What sometime you have to prove it to me. I challenge you in front of everybody to prove that this hadith is false. Go ahead, I'm listening. You have the hadith number, you have the name of the book, you have the reference.
Let me go to sunnah.com.
Okay.
What's the number of that hadith?
1453A. 1453A.
In Sahih Muslim, yeah?
Yes.
145?
Yes.
15,
145? My friend, three. What this drama is about? You search the hadith. How many times I need to repeat for you?
To be honest, I cannot comment on that hadith. Let's move to another issue.
Okay, read with me. This is Tafsir Surah An-Nisa, variant number one. Part number 136. Tafsir who? Read with me carefully.
Okay.
ذهب جمهور أهل العلم أن الرضاعة الذي يحرم etc 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 and then he continues speaking about قصة سهلة مع سالم مولى أبي حذيفة وقول النبي أرضعيه قالت وكيف أرضعه وهو رجل كبير. How I'm going to do breastfeeding but yet he is an old man. And look what they are saying here, that this is reported by صحيح البخاري. أخرج this is the story, all of it is أخرج في البخاري 2 to 51 ومسلم 1455 ومن حديث عائشة قالت دخل عليها وعندها رجل فكأنه تغير وجهه كأنه كره ذلك فقالت إنه أخي فقال انظرنا ما أخوانكم فإنما الرضاعة من المجاعة. Even the wife of Muhammad, she ordered her sister to do breastfeeding for anyone when I come upon her, which means her, she became like her secretary. And if you want to enter upon Aisha, you have to ask, you have to go to the sister of Aisha and you suck her boobs for 10 times, different time, not in the same day, until you are satisfied. And you are the one who said to me, this is sexual intimacy, correct?
What was the age of the kid?
They are men, my friend.
And I have to ask this. I have to verify this situation, man. I don't trust you. So for that reason, I cannot comment.
My friend, let me show you from Al-Imam.
I cannot comment what I don't know.
Let me show. Have you ever heard of Al-Qurtubi?
I do not know, man. I have to ask.
My
That's
friend,
why I said I cannot comment.
No problem.
You're forcing me to say something.
This is Al-Imam Al-Qurtubi. This is Imam Al-Qurtubi, volume number 2. Hold on. Volume number 17, verse number 65. Here they are talking about Imam Al-Qurtubi. And Imam Al-Qurtubi says, and this is the book in the front of your eyes. It says, وَلَأَنَّ عَائِشَ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهَا كَانَتْ إِذَا أَرَادَتْ دُخُولَ رَجُلٍ عَلَيْهَا أَمَرَتْ أُخْتَهَا أَسْمَاءَ أَنْ تُرْضِعُهُ لِيُصِيرَ لَهَا إِبْنًا لِأُخْتِهَا مِنَ الرِّضَاعَةِ. And if Aisha, she wants any man.
No problem.
Listen, my friend, and Aisha, if she wants anyone to enter upon her, a rajul, a man, she ordered her sister to suck her boobs so he can become a son for her from breastfeeding. You are the one who said to me, if you do suck a woman's breast, it is sexual intimacy. Do you agree
That's
with that?
Between wife and a man.
My friend, between wife and a man. What about a wife and a stranger? A woman and a stranger.
No,
she's a stranger. He is a stranger. Oh, okay. Are you saying to me, I'm not trying to insult you. Are you saying to me that you have no problem with somebody want to visit you? Listen. Are you saying you have no problem that a man come to your house and he sucked the boobs of your wife?
You're not allowing me to speak, man.
I'm asking you.
When I said sexual intimacy, I was referring to the between a wife and a husband, not a stranger. What about stranger?
What we would do with a stranger now? We have a stranger, a man he wanna enter upon. Let us say you have a wife, and then your wife she ordered her sister to give her boobs to me to suck it, and then I can go and see your wife. Is that logical for you? Is that acceptable in Islam?
Not even logic, man.
Well, this is what it says in front of you.
I doubt it. I highly doubt it.
What do you mean I doubt it? Here we go. This is Tafsir Al-Qurtubi.
My friend,
it doesn't matter. I don't care if you're Arabic. You can go check it out. No problem, my friend. Take your time. I'm not forcing you right now. My friend. I show it to you in English, so you have no excuse. I show it to you in English, and I show it to you.
I cannot comment on the issue. I do not know
okay.
What you mean.
Let me ask you. Why you call me? Let us change the topic, just to give you a chance to breathe.
That's why I said bring another issue. I do not comment.
I don't want to bring another issue. I want you to
first of all, my Arabic language.
I want you no problem.
I have to ask people of knowledge.
No problem.
In the Quran it says.
I don't want to ask you something.
Listen to me, man. Listen. Let me mention my point. In the Quran it says that if you do not know, ask the people of knowledge.
Who are the people of knowledge?
They have three characteristics. They have to be a righteous people. People who are the imam or someone who you trust.
Not true.
And also, not also
true.
Someone who's proficient in the Arabic language
not
and, true. And all the divine laws.
That's false, my friend. The Quran says, if you want to know, ask the Christians and the Jews.
So if I need now scholar, I have to go to the grave or what?
The Quran says, thank you very much. Those who they recite the scriptures
right.
before you. Okay, we are the one. You ask
part
us.
Of your answer is right. Part so, of your answer is right that during the Islamic history where the Quraysh lived, they were Jewish people. So they used to go to ask them the Bani Israel, the stories that happened. And we take benefit from those. And the Prophet said, do not say when the narrators of the Jewish come to you that they narrate you the past story during the Moses time, do not tell them that you guys are lying and do not verify them until you know that you can take benefit. Because some remember during that time there was oral tradition. Remember, we never used to have cameras, we never used to have technology.
Okay, so my friend, let us go to something else. As long as
no,
I'm talking, let us talk. My friend, you told me whatever you want to say, and you're wasting my time. I told you what the criteria in the Quran. You have to ask the Christian and the Jews. Only. The Quran never said. The Quran never say. Never say. The Quran. Hold on. The Quran never say. And you agreed. Never say to you, go and ask someone is a Muslim. He said to you, go and ask the Christian and the Jews.
That's why I said part of your answer is right, but not complete.
No, it's complete because you have to show me if you can ask a Muslim. Where it says go and ask Muslim?
I gave you a scenario.
My friend. Let me ask you a question. No, you are wasting my time. You are wasting my time. I don't want to talk about this. Here we go. We got a confirmation that you need to ask the Christians, for you Muslims are ignorant. This is what the Quran is saying. Even the Quran call us people of the book. Why the Quran does not call you people of the book?
Why would I ask someone who worshiped Jesus who was breastfed by a woman? Why would I ask someone who's irrational?
Well, you are irrational. You are the one who believed that
you Jesus.
My friend, hold on. Let us see how funny it is. Worship. You are the one who follow a man. He ordered your wife to give her boobs to a stranger.
Who's more logical? You,
is that rational for you? Is that rational for you? What is your dignity? What is your dignity? What is the man on you? Shame on you. Shame on you to follow a prophet. Shame on you to follow a prophet. He teaches you such a thing.
Who's more logical? You are worshipping someone who was breastfed, who was washed.
Prove it to me that Jesus was breastfed. I want to see it. Read it. I want to see it. Show me. Are you saying your prophet was a liar? Are you saying your prophet was a liar?
I'm asking you a question.
Are you saying because the Quran says that Jesus, he spoke in day number one and he was a mature person, yes or no?
Why are you turning away the topic?
You are the one who talking about Jesus breastfeeding now.
Do not divert the topic,
brother. Elijah means God is with us. Bring me Muhammad hijab. Don't go in circle. Don't go in circle. The one you are making fun of, the one you are making fun of, he is right now in heaven. Let me ask you, how Jesus he did breastfeeding, but yet he can resurrect people from the grave. Answer me.
You're not allowing me to speak.
No, I am allowed in you, but you try to change the topic. I want you not to escape. How Jesus for you is just a person who did the breastfeeding according to you, but you cannot prove it. But yet he was able to resurrect people from the grave. I want to know.
I do not worship him.
I worship him because he can resurrect people from death.
How can you worship someone?
Because he is God. The proof is the following. The proof that he can make the blind see. He resurrect people from death. He bring people to life. He forgive your sin. He is right now in heaven, even in your book. So how dare you to say, okay, explain to me why you worship Allah when Allah cannot create a fly?
You are changing topics, man.
You are the one who's talking to me about worshiping Jesus. I'm showing you. What's wrong with you? Are you stupid or what? Just go. I have no time for kids. Guys, is it him who start talking about why you worship Jesus as a breastfeeding? He was breastfed by his mother. We were talking about breastfeeding. He keep jumping like a monkey from topic to topic. I showed him all the reference, all the proof, and he didn't want to make a comment about it. He said, I need to ask the scholars. I showed him that the Quran says you need to ask the Christians, not the scholars. The Quran says that, and I am a Christian prince. Even your stupid book says to you, in order to learn, you need to ask the Christian and the Jews. And you are saying, I'm changing topic? What Jesus have to do with our topic? Why you jump to Jesus? Why you jump to worshiping Jesus? And yet he's accusing me, I am changing topic. What kind of religion, what kind of people who have no dignity? You have to be a person who have no dignity to follow a man ordering an adult woman to give her boobs to a strange man. And you are the one in the beginning start making fun of this, what I said, and you said this is sexual intimacy. It is you who said that. You admitted that any man, he suck a woman boobs, a man, we are talking about children, it is sexual intimacy, and you said that. So what Muhammad is doing here? Why he is ordering women and adult women to suck, to give her boobs to a stranger? What is the wisdom behind that? Since when we can make a person my son and he is a man by sucking the boobs of or the nipples of a woman? You know me, guys? This is how stupid this religion is, and yet I am the one who changed the topic. Hey Abdul, how are you?
I'm good.
Okay, so now I showed you the proof that this is, and your friend, the one who called after you, he confirmed that that verse is about people who they are not married. What do you say?
I don't give a damn what they say.
Are you saying your brother Muhammad Hijab is a donkey? Shut up. I don't give a damn. His ass get hurt, you know. There is no verse in the Quran for stoning, for adultery in the Quran. Where the verse is gone? The answer is very simple. The goat ate it. There's a holy goat, may Allah bless her belly, ate priceless verses in the Quran. And until now it's wanted. If you go right now to the FBI in Saudi Arabia website, you will find a picture of a goat. It says wanted, alive or dead. Take a note, please. We need to open her stomach immediately. Why you are calling me back if you are going to fight? Hello?
What? Yes.
So are you going to answer me or not? Where is the punishment for adultery in the case of married women?
I said, I'm not going to tell you till you deny that it's not in the Quran. If you deny that...
Where is the verse?
Deny it first.
Where?
It doesn't matter. It's not relevant. That's not relevant.
What do you mean irrelevant?
Let's talk about something relevant. Is it in the Quran or not?
Listen, I see your name. It says Sheikh Taylor. Are you a sheikh?
I said, is it in the Quran or not?
It is not.
Oh, that was in the Quran?
The verse about stoning to death is not in the Quran for adultery.
No. I'm talking about the verse about 100 lashes. That's why I don't believe in
but
that.
But this is not what about married women. And the hadith I showed you, your prophet wife, she said the goat ate the Quran. Let me ask you. Are you saying your prophet wife, she did lie? She is a liar when she said that?
I think that Arab people like you lied on her.
Who are they, those Arabs? They are Muslims. Why the Muslims, they are lying, saying Aisha, she said, if she did not say. This guy is a sheikh. By the way, this guy is a sheikh in a mosque and he is losing his career. This is why he's shouting. Let me ask you, Abdul. I have a challenge for you. To show me one interpretation in the word agree with you. Is that fair?
Rashad Khalifa.
Rashad Khalifa, he said this one. Rashad Khalifa was killed by the Muslims. He's not Muslim. He was killed by the Muslims because he deleted verse from the Quran.
Now you gotta decide who's Muslim and who's not.
Rashid Khalifa is not a scholar, Abdul. He's a guy, he just died 15 years ago. Are you stupid or what?
You gotta go by the book.
Abdul, I say to you, show me one Islamic interpretation. One Islamic interpretation. Believe that the verse, this verse is about married people.
Okay, let me ask you one question. Can I ask you a question?
Yeah, you can ask me your question, except the size of my shoe.
Okay, now tell me, if Allah anywhere in the world, if Allah says a man or a woman who fornicates got 100 lashes, does it need any interpretation to say that this law is talking about married or not married man? In Arabic, does it say married man or married woman?
No, again, no, it doesn't say that. But that proved that the Quran is not a perfect book. That is a proof that the Quran is a bad book. Because why Allah did not say that there is a difference between the punishment?
Let me finish and answer my question. Let me finish my question and answer it. Let me finish my question. I want the world to hear that you're a liar. Listen to me. Let me ask you one question and answer. You ready?
Let me get ready. Hold on. Let me put my shoes on. Hold on.
Law in the world.
Hold on.
Says,
I'm not ready. Please hold on. Let me breathe. Okay. Yeah. No. Okay. Ask me.
I said, if Allah says, does it say in Arabic, when Allah says azaniya to azani, does it mean a married or not married? No. He said any woman fornicates or any man fornicates. Why would you married or not married? He didn't say married or not married. He said any woman. Just like you said, any woman or man who steals got their hand cut off. Okay. It didn't make a difference between married woman and...
Okay. Can I talk now? Can I talk now?
Huh?
Is it okay? Can I talk? I can talk? Your Majesty, yes. Your Majesty, can I talk? Okay. So, can you explain to me why all the Muslim scholars, they say this is about unmarried women and unmarried men? Why they are saying that? I mean, you are a person who doesn't speak Arabic.
Yes.
And those are Arab. Yes. All of them, all the scholars, Al-Jalalain, Ibn Abbas, Al-Qurtubi, Al-Tabari, you name it, Ibn Kathir, all of them, they are saying about those, this is about unmarried women. So I want your Majesty to explain to us why all the Muslims look like they are donkeys. They do not know what the Quran is saying, but you are the horse. Go ahead. Explain to us.
Okay. Yep. Okay. I'm going to tell you. I'm going to tell you what happened. In the time of Maria, do you know who Maria is?
No, I never heard of him. He's still alive?
Maria is after Abu Bakr. It was Omar, right? After Omar, it was when Osman died, Ali was supposed to be taken over, right?
Are you a Shia?
Yes.
You are a Shia?
Ali was supposed to, but yes. Those are the Shias are following. But Maria took over. It was a fight between, you know, between Maria and the Shia people, right? Maria's wife got caught fornicating. And then she was supposed to be beaten 100 lashes. Maria said, no. I want her to die. I don't want her to leave. He said to Abu Huraira, create me a hadith. I'm going to give you a tool. I'm going to give you a gift. Create me a hadith and help me kill her. Because my wife don't deceive me.
Okay.
So they created a hadith. They said, a lady came to the Prophet Muhammad and said, hey, ya Rasulullah, I fornicated. He said, what? He said, I fornicated. I'm pregnant.
Is that story long? Make it short.
No.
Okay.
No, make it short. At the end of the day, the Prophet told her, go till you got your baby and come back. And then she went, got the baby and come back. And the Prophet said, go ahead and come back in 2 years. She came back 2 years later, and they said that they said, Maria created hadith, and they said the Prophet killed her. The Prophet never killed nobody. Allah said in the Quran, the biggest oath in the Quran is about Muhammad saying anything that is not the Quran. Fala uqsimu bima tubsirun wa ma la tubsirun.
Okay. And what does this have to do with my topic, Abdul? What does this have to do with my topic? What are you talking about? I'm sleepy now. What is the answer? Let me. You see, I gave you 5 minutes to say, and you said nothing. Let me get you busted. Read with me carefully.
Oh, okay.
Let me read carefully. A woman, if you said a zani and zania, does not mean a woman, she is married or not, right?
I want you to be honest. I want you to translate exactly for people. What does it mean? Since you understand Arabic.
My friend. Let me show you how stupid you are. Let me show you how stupid you are. Officially certified donkey. The same chapter we are reading, you donkey. It says in chapter 24, verse number 3, الزاني لا ينكح إلا زانية أو مشركة والزانية لا ينكحها إلا زان أو مشرك. So this is not about married. He's saying, and a woman, she is an adulteress. No man can. What?
Translate the verse.
I will translate. Here we go. Don't shout. Here go. This is Yusuf Ali, Abdul Potato. And those who launch charge against chastity women. Abdul, read with me. Let no man guilty of adultery or fornication marry, but a woman similar guilty. And this is the word here is used, Zania. This is the verse after it right away. This is the verse after it. So now he's talking about the second punishment. Shut up. The second punishment for those who committed adultery is you cannot marry as an adulterer unless you marry an adulterer like you. So they are not married. This is why they are not married. A woman, she is not married. She cannot marry except a man who is adulterer like her. If she is married, how she is going to marry again?
Let me tell you how wrong you are.
Abdul, what about we do this? What if we go to the Shia interpretation? What if we go to the Shia interpretation and get you busted? Is that fair? If we go, what we go? Why we don't go to the Shia? As long as you are a Shia. Can we go to the Shia interpretation? Can we go to the Shia interpretation? Yes or no? Shut up. Don't call me again. What a donkey. Okay, you are a Sunni, you are a Shia, you are not a Sunni. I understand. You are from different religion, worshipping Muhammad and his family, and they think they are made from light. And obviously, Muhammad was from light. Even his mother, she said when she gave birth to him, a light came from her vagina and reached all the way to Damascus. At that time, I was in Iraq, and I saw the light myself. And now the light there. What a stupid donkey. Why you don't want to go? Okay, you don't want to go with the Sunni? We go to the Shia. Hello?
Hello?
Yes, my friend. How are you?
Hello.
Did you check the reference I gave you, Mr. Muhammad?
Yes, you said the unmarried couple is not found in the Quran. I agree with you. We agree on that? Yes or no?
Yeah, but I asked you to go and check about the breastfeeding for adult.
Yes, the hadith is found in Sahih Muslim 1690. You can check it from yourself. He's saying if a married woman or woman commits adultery, then they are to be stoned.
No, this is not the topic. I asked you, you said you want to go and check about the breastfeeding for adult. So, what happened with that?
So now we are not dealing with the phone.
No, this is with this Abdul. This guy is a Shia. Now, you know, we spoke, me and you, for some time.
Let's address this topic
okay.
now.
So what happened now with the breastfeeding? Did you search? Did you
not
find an answer?
You want me to address the adultery or the breastfeeding?
No, let us finish the breastfeeding. Your specialty is breastfeeding. His specialty is the adultery. Let's go. So
I said,
what did you find?
Look,
my friend, this is not my topic. So don't tell me. So you have no answer. Is that the
I
answer?
Is that the answer?
You have no answer.
Which topic do you want me to address?
Do you have an answer or not? Do you have an answer or not? Make it short. Do you have an answer or not?
I cannot comment.
Okay, then let us change the topic. What do you want to talk about?
I want to talk about the part where the fornication part.
Okay, go ahead.
I agree with you that the married couple, the Quran did not mention it. Only mentioned unmarried. So the other one, we rely on the Sunnah.
Okay.
The legal traditions.
What the Sunnah says about married women and married men.
Narrated by Abu Muslim. 1690. That's the hadith. Okay. It's saying if an unmarried person commits fornication with it's saying if a married woman or woman commits adultery, then they are to be stoned to death because the Prophet, peace be upon him,
that's wonderful. Okay, so now this is you know, but this is me, but this is me, my friend, but this is me that the Quran is not a perfect book. Because why it's not in the Quran? I mean, this is something extremely important.
You cannot take only the Quran, our two sources. We have two sources, brother.
So Islam is not Islam is no problem, no problem. Even Shia have hadith, my friend. Even Shia, they have hadith more than you. Who told you Shia don't have it? The Shia they have hadith more than the Muslim Sunni 3-4 times more. What are you talking about?
Let me state my point. Please give me a chance. Yeah. Let me state my point. Okay. We rely on two sources. The divine laws are two sources, the Sunnah and the Quran. Mm. We cannot take the Quran only because that's illegal. It's not allowed.
Okay, read with me carefully.
Because the context will get lost.
My friend, this is Sahih al-Bukhari. This is authentic hadith. This is Umar.
Then why are you relying on Bukhari if you are not allowing me to use also that? Because the tradition of hadith is also part of our religion. Why are you saying we only rely on the Quran? What's your point, brother?
No, you see, I'm saying to you, we rely on the hadith. We are relying on the hadith, but where is the hadith?
That's my point.
Where is the No, you see, we have a problem here. We have a problem. You are saying we rely in the hadith, but we cannot find in the hadith the verse of stoning to death. What is the verse?
I said we have two divine laws.
You don't get my point. Are you saying the hadith is divine?
Yes, it's divine. Well,
so how you say to me? How you say to me that 5 minutes ago that the divine is da'if?
Divine law is what I mean is that divine laws, the Quran.
My friend, are you to the one who said to me, da'if, how it is hadith is divine for you, but is involving da'if, involve weak, involve corruption. How it is divine, but it's corrupt.
When it's da'if, it means the chain of narration, there were liars.
Okay, so is it accepted or not? Is it accepted or not? Is it accepted or not?
It's a different case.
Is it accepted or not?
Let me explain.
Is da'if accepted or not? Give me an answer. Don't explain. No, either you say it is accepted or you say it is not.
Da'if hadith, we do not rely.
Okay. So you just confirm. You just confirm that you have. You just confirm. You just confirm that you have a divine law. It's called the hadith and full of corruption. Thank you very much. How that can be?
Be fair. Give me a chance now to speak.
Go ahead.
What I said is we have two sources. We have the Quran and the hadith. I said both of them, they are considered divine laws because the Prophet Muhammad never talked through his desires. Go to Surah Najm, the start of the ayah, it says, وَمَا يَنْطِقُ عَنِ الْهَوَىٰ إِنْ هُوَ إِلَّا وَحْيُّ يُوحَىٰ. You understand Arabic, brother? It means the Prophet never spoke through his desires. All his speech was from the revelation. Mm. Angel Gabriel came to him, he revealed to him.
Mm. Let me ask you, did I hear you saying the chapter of an-Najm? Is that correct?
Yeah, Surah Najm.
Why it's called the chapter of an-Najm?
An-Najm, it means the stars, yeah?
Okay, is it true that Allah, he swear by the star?
Because he's the creator, he can do whatever he wants.
Okay, if Allah create the cockroach, if Allah create the cockroach, he will swear by the cockroach?
He can do anything.
Is it true in the Quran, Allah, he swear by the fig?
Yes, he can do anything.
What's wrong with this God? We know when somebody swear, he swear by something greater than him.
What do you mean how?
When somebody swear, he swear by something greater than him. Why Allah swear by the fig and the cockroach?
He's the creator. He can do whatever he want. We don't question him.
Okay, so how come he can do whatever he want, but he cannot be a man? How come he swear? He can swear by the fig, but he cannot be a man.
What's your point?
Well, you see, the second we ask you about something impossible to believe, that God is swearing by something silly and stupid like the fig or cockroach,
the
and then
he
it's okay, he's the creator. Want. Okay, as long as you agree he is the creator, he can do whatever he wants. How come he cannot? How come he cannot be a man as long as he can do whatever he wants? He's the creator. A second ago, you told me he's the creator. He can do whatever he wants. Abdul, listen.
I don't understand.
In the chapter of An-Najm, let me show you something silly about your religion. I'm not insulting you, by the way. I hope you want to take it as an insult. This is how I talk. Is it true that in the chapter of An-Najm, your prophet, he said to his cousin, because he said,
brother and sister, you see, he's not honest.
My friend, you are the one who mentioned the chapter of An-Najm. You are the one who mentioned the chapter of An-Najm. I let you speak. It's my time to speak. Is it true your prophet, he said to his cousin, because he refused to believe in the Lord of the Star, did he say to him, you are a kafir? Yes or no?
Why are you jumping the topics, brother?
We are not changing the topic. You are the one who mentioned the chapter of An-Najm, not me.
I said the God can swear whatever he wants because
no problem. Is it true that in the chapter of An-Najm, is it true that your God in the chapter of An-Najm, your prophet, he explained that Allah, he have a dog?
Where in which verse?
The chapter of An-Najm.
He didn't do that. You are liar.
Okay. Do you are you willing to challenge me?
Where's the reference? Give me the reference.
Are you willing to challenge me?
From your own words.
Are you willing to challenge me? What if I show you the reference?
Go to Surah An-Najm now. Let's go. Which verse is it?
No, I will show. I said your prophet said. I did not say the Quran said. Are you willing to challenge me?
That's not trustworthy. That's not authority.
It's not authority. So you see, guys, anything is embarrassing. Anything is embarrassing is not authority. When they want, it is authority. When they want, it's not authority.
No, remove the
Is that the game? You know, is that the Abdul?
What's your proof?
Okay, I will show you the proof. Here we go. Okay, no problem.
Remove the proof. Surah An-Najm, we can go now.
Mm-hmm. All right.
Don't like your Christian brothers and sisters, please.
My friend. Here we go. What do you want? You want the proof, don't you? Don't you want, my friend? Don't you want the proof? Don't you want the proof? Okay. Here we go. We'll make you read it.
Which surah is that?
The only religion, the God of that religion, have a dog is Islam.
Where's the reference? Put it on the screen.
It's in the screen.
Where? I cannot see any
chapter of An-Najm. Chapter of An-Najm, Tafsir al-Tabari, page number, volume number 23, page number 493, 494, 495. It says here, your prophet, he said to his cousin.
Why are you
saying okay, what do you want? What do you want? What tafsir you want? What tafsir you want?
I want the Quran. Go to the Quran. Where is the?
Well, this is. You see, this is how hypocrite you are. So if I try to explain the Quran up to myself, you say to me, you cannot do that. You have to go to tafsir. When I show you your Islamic Sunni tafsir, this guy is not a Sufi. This guy is a Muslim Sunni. So now what we will
give
do?
Give me the first.
Ibn Abbas. What's the first? Ibn Abbas. Yeah. You like Ibn Abbas? You like Ibn Abbas?
What's the verse?
What?
What's the chapter? Give me the reference from the Quran, and then I can go to explanation.
Okay, here we go. No problem.
Give me the chapter and
when Najmu is a Hawa, the chapter of An-Najm, verse number 1. I told you already.
Surah An-Najm is 53, chapter 53.
The chapter of An-Najm, verse number 1.
Verse number 1, yeah? Mm-hmm. It's saying when Najmu is a Hawa, by the star of descent.
Yes. Your prophet, he said to his companion, his cousin, he said to him, "Ama takhaf an ya'kuluka kalbullah? Aren't you afraid that Allah dog will eat you?"
No, you are a liar. That's not Surah An-Najm, man.
Abdul, don't tell me I'm lying. I'm showing it in screen. People will laugh at you.
You didn't quote the verse. Where's the verse?
Strip it. I am quoting the interpretation.
No, that's not reliable, man.
Not real. So look like you Muslims, you have a religion, nothing in it in reliable. I mean, whatever I quote for you.
You said the Quran.
How you know it is not reliable? How you know that? How you get that conclusion, my friend? How fast are you in getting the answer, right? You are the fastest computer ever. Anything I say to you, you say it's not reliable.
When Najmi ida hawa, that's the verse. It's saying by the star when it descends.
Okay, what happened in that story?
That's a star. God swore.
What happened in that story? Explain to me what this story is about.
It's apparent meaning. What do they want you to explain?
What happened? No, there is explanation. You as a Muslim, if you want to learn about this story, what happened? Where do you go?
You see, now our scholars become godly divine. Yeah?
Where do you go? See, guys, now his scholars, they are godly divine. A second ago, so you are saying to me we should not go to the scholars? Are you saying that?
Scholars are not infallible.
Who cares if they are infallible or not? All your religion, all the hadith is coming from what? It's coming from men, a human being like you. Your prophet is a human being like you. So how come all of them, they are not infallible, but Muhammad is not infallible? Isn't it Muhammad? Let me ask you. You said وَمَا يَنْطِقُ عَنِ الْهَوَى. Muhammad, you don't say anything except from Allah. Is that correct?
Yes.
Okay. Can you explain to me the chapter of At-Tahrim?
Now you jumped another topic.
No, I'm showing you that you are a hypocrite. The Quran says that Muhammad is a liar. Muhammad, he fabricates his own.
You see, get lost.
Don't call me. I want adult to call me. Please give me an adult. Each time I show them the reference in the front of their face, they say it's not reliable, with no proof. Anything I show them, the easiest answer, it is not accepted.